And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda. I'm the RPG chick. We are ready to head to one of these worlds. Onaon. Something. Okay. Aya? Oh, I guess Onaon is the name of the system, right? So Aya is a small and lush tropical world. Its unique position, hidden by both the Scourge and Helios's black hole, has allowed it to go undetected by the cat. Alert! Aya is a sovereign world of the Angara. All initiative personnel must conform to early contact protocols. Hold on a second. Go to either Avarl or Voeld. Right, so that's not one of the places. So what happens if I try to land here again? Will they get pissed at me? Kinda curious. Oh, will we just land? We'll probably just land and be back at the docks and not be able to see anything else. Curious. We're probably either not going to get anywhere, or this is going to be a bad decision. Because we have returned with no results. Me and my curiosity. I like to see what happens in certain situations. No, just back on the docks again.
I'm here. How may I help you, Pathfinder?
Okay.
Thanks for your time, Enro.
Of course.
Yeah, we're just back here. We can't... I'm sure we can't go any farther than this, either. Yeah, locked, locked. Okay. Oh. So can we skip this? Tab? Space? Nope. Pretty cool watching it fly off, so I won't fast forward it. Hope you guys don't mind. Looks like a bird almost collided with us and I was in front. And way down more, so...
Pathfinder, are we going to Vold or Havarl?
That's what I'm trying to figure out.
At your terminal, Pathfinder.
Oh, I have email? Oh crap, let me read the email. They'd be like, why the hell did you go back on Aya again, Pathfinder? You have broken our trust. Poker awaits. To Ryder from Gil. Ryder, the bells toll for thee. Meet me in the vortex on Nexus. I'll be the one shuffling the deck of doom. Cheers, Gil. Well, we're not going to the Nexus right now. Okay, let's head for one of these, and we're going to check out other planets, of course, if there are any. First, we're going to look at this whole system, so... That might be this episode?
I'm picking up something.
Cool. Yeah, picking up a lot of something. His May we have Sansiol, Obairu, Fetfun. May Rav. Now I'm not fast-forwarding these, I'm not skipping. On return trips, I will. But I kinda like seeing all this. That's awesome. Look at the flares off the sun. Alright, so... The Angara have established a research station on the boiling toxic surface of May Rav, but it appears unmanned and in danger of destruction. Perhaps the Angara lack the resources to maintain it. We can't find this station, right? I can't launch a thing. Okay.
Anomaly on sensors.
Anomaly? Well, let's look at the planets first. The anomaly might be on one of the planets. Obiro. Or Obeiro. I love the, galaxy song. Oh, I've got some Scourge there. It's similar, yet different. To the original tune of the,
Anomaly on sensors.
The anomalies here. To the original tune of the, Mass Effect trilogy. Okay, we've got an anomaly that way. Surface temperature is 77 Celsius. Obeiro's surface is primarily composed of iron, but mountains rich with less common metals dot the landscape. Scans indicate that the Angara have often sent mining expeditions here.
Deploying probe. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Cool. Graphite. This graphite mineral deposit should prove useful to the initiative for manufacturing. Plus 99. Anything else? Nothing else here, okay.
I'm picking up something.
Yeah, probably. Let's check out senses, y'all. You are here. Boom.
Anomaly on sensors.
Despite its comfortable temperature and gravity, Sensizule's composition is highly toxic and inimical to most life forms. It would be difficult at best to colonize.
Probe away. Satellite detected.
Cool. Satellite ID unknown. Power readings are 4.2%. It's almost run down. Functional but dormant. Status active. A cat satellite is well concealed low in Sensizule's orbit, doubtless designed to observe Angaran activities in the system. Disabling it permanently is a simple task. A simple task. We gain 50 Helios research data. Can we disable it? I'd like to just shoot the thing. I don't know what else we can do. There's no option. Well, I want to disable it, but I don't see an option for it. Anything else? No. Okay.
Anomaly on sensors.
Well, we haven't tried Fetfun yet, or its moon, I guess that is. Boop. That's cool. I like how we can see both of them at once. Ooh, with a greenish tinge to the atmosphere. Every century, Fetfun's orbital path takes it dangerously near a stretch of Scourge. It appears to be bleeding atmosphere as a consequence. Huh. Well, said there was an anomaly, but... Ooh! Looks like an eye. See that? The other pole. Alright, the same, just different color. I guess there's no anomaly here.
Anomaly on sensors.
Oh. Something here.
Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Oh, asteroid here, okay. Cool. I love that sun, that star. G-type asteroid. This asteroid contains large quantities of frozen water, unusual for this particular asteroid belt and a possible host for microbial life. And there's a beryllium deposit. 145 beryllium. Any more anomalies? Nope. Okay, so I guess we're leaving this system. It's not one of the two planets we can land on. And I didn't see an option to land. I wasn't looking for one, but... What else do we have? Oh my. Meet the resistance, Voweld. Or helping Havarl's scientists at Havarl. Okay, so we've seen these. These two are new. Gerator and Furrowing. And then there's Sabeng, Nalesh, Joba, and our destination is Nor. Let's go to Sabeng. Yeah, so this episode is probably just going to be system exploring. Doctor Who journeys.
This system looks mostly unexplored.
Cool.
It was charted once.
What's that?
Then this scourge happened. What's old is new.
What the hell is this?
Anomaly detected.
Is that the anomaly? Let's look at the planets first. Wow, there's a long space between the third and fourth planet here. So let's check out Jestier. It looks like that one planet has a tiny star overhead. The one beyond this one. Oh, over there. Sabeng. Named by the Angara for a word meaning roughly tranquil stone plain, Jestier was reduced to a world of lava and electrical storms by the power of the Scourge. Doesn't seem like there's anything here. You know, I just want to check something.
I'm picking up something.
You sure are. I want to zoom out, though. Onaon is 100% good. Just making sure that... Oh, we can zoom in like that? Alright. Let's go to Paz 33. Interesting name. Boop. I love that we hear the old boop sound. In the background. Kind of muted. But it makes me feel nostalgic. Let me play these games, the original trilogy, a year ago.
Anomaly on sensors.
Already I have, like, nostalgia for it. So we have an anomaly, and... Paz 33. This unusually small and unusually tranquil gas giant was unknown until recently. Whether it simply went undiscovered or was wildly changed by the scourge is unclear. Hmm, interesting. Could be it was once not so tranquil.
Deploying probe.
I love that we got deploying probe. Was she saying that the whole time? Because kind of running together. Probe away. I used to say that in Mass Effect 3, I believe. So we've got a satellite. Oh, it's Nexus 0924-F. Power readings 55.3%. System report. Databanks prepped for download. Status operational. Analysis. One of many satellites distributed by scouts from the Nexus. This unnamed station has been diligently studying the unusual features of PAS 33. Milky Way research data. So we are getting, yeah, much research data. Awesome. Nothing else to see. I'm waiting to see if there's a moment where we'll have two things to find on one planet.
Anomaly on sensors.
Well, it's either here, here, or this thing. Let's check out PAS 13. What's the PAS stand for? So we're more than halfway done of tracking, scanning planets across the across Helios cluster. Ooh. This scourge is so creepy looking, isn't it? It's pretty, but creepy looking. Sabeng. Oh, that's the name of the system. PAS 13. Wild plant growth flourishes on PAS 13 beneath thick surface ice. Only the crushing atmosphere makes PAS 13 inappropriate for mining frozen water. This is cool. You can see lightning and stuff. I love it. Must be some storm to see it from this far away.
Anomaly on sensors.
We're going to check out this last planet and then see if there's another anomaly. Probably is. This thing, that thing right there, is very suspicious looking. I don't know what that is. Wow.
Anomaly detected.
Cool. PAS 15. Seas of liquid helium cover this strange world, reliably boiling whenever the temperature rises. Probe away.
Probe away.
Hey.
Getting a scan.
Getting a scan. So there's an ice sheet, 30 million kilometers in the surface area. The composition is 84% helium. The status is stable. Analysis. Helium freezes only at incredibly low temperatures and under severe pressure. In certain rare and intriguing circumstances, PAS 15 provides both. I got 270 experience. I guess just we learned something. Okay. Nothing else? Okay.
I'm picking up something.
Are you picking up this?
Probes launched.
Of course.
Anomaly found.
Oh, it's element zero? We're gonna go get it. Cool. Is all that element zero, or there's element zero within it somewhere? What is all this? A lot of twinkly twinklies. Ooh. This deposit of helium zero... element zero. Element zero appears to have originated with the destruction of a large starship, though this is difficult to confirm. 22 element zero. Nice. It's so pretty. Nothing else. So I guess we fully explored the system. Yeah, 100%. Cool. Done. Next, we'll go to Nalesh. Bye, Element Zero. What about all these other Element Zeros?
Wealth from this system once fed industry on Vold. And well beyond.
Oh.
One day that might be true again.
That's cool to hear Jal talking.
I'm picking up something.
I'm not going to do research data right now, thank you. So in the Nalesh system, the first planet is Tijarana. Guessing that's how it's pronounced. I love the system exploration. I wish the descriptions were a little longer, like in the first game. Okay, yes. You guys can probably hear that. That is a bird. It's very hot in my room. I cannot, well, my office anyway, I can't really close the windows. And this bird starts singing really early. What time is it? It's 4:30 in the morning. Tijarana. An Angaran. Angaran poet named Tijarana as the gemstone eye of Nalesh. Its limestone surface glimmers with copper deposits, though few explorers have ever made planetfall. Okay. Next.
Anomaly detected.
Second planet from the sun, Rahir. Rahir. I don't quite know how to, you know, pronounce these names. Could be one of two or three ways. Meteors impact Rahir regularly, bringing the riches of the asteroid belt to the planet's surface. Nothing to find.
Up something.
You sure are. Let's check out the third planet. Gesaimo? Gesaimo? 30 out of 50 planets, guys. Gold and aluminum dominate Gesaimo's surface. Much of the equipment used by the Angara to mine the planet remains intact, albeit damaged and non-functional. Nothing to find here.
Anomaly detected.
Okay, final planet. Suyorna? However you pronounce it, here we come. Ooh, it showed me the description for a second. Oh, there was a description of something else, though, because it looked longer. So Siorna's gravity frequently captures passing asteroids. Most plunge into its gaseous atmosphere, but a few remain permanently in orbit. Nothing to see.
Anomaly detected.
And we've got anomaly detected. This little twinkle here, I guess.
Deploying probe. Got a reading from the asteroid belt.
Starship wreckage. Let's check it out. I hope we can go on to some Starcraft, like Starship Wreckage. Look around and stuff. Like the MSV, you know, different things that we used to find. The MSV Strontium Mule, I remember, because it's the craziest name. Cool. Flashing. Ship identity unknown. Ship name unknown. Crew complement unknown. Status not available. This Ket mining vessel appears to have been torn apart from the inside. Likely a mechanical failure. The destruction seems to be recent. We got a bunch of crap that we can sell at a merchant. Enzymatic injectors, optoelectric module, bionascent converter. Yeah, whatever. I'll sell it. I probably need to go sell at this point. Before we leave, I want to check. Item limit 39 out of 100. Okay, we got plenty. Because we just picked up a lot of stuff there. They just increased it. It was 50. And so they've increased it. Oh, cool. You can see that outside the window. That's awesome. That is really awesome. I didn't know. I didn't realize. That's pretty cool. Watch out. That might hit the windshield. We're going to be fine. So yeah, there are perks or whatever you call it. Skills that you can take. Abilities. To increase that to, I believe, up to 200. There's like two different ones. I'm not sure if I'm going to be taking them. We'll have to see if we look at the bottom of it. It almost looks like it has little legs. Or, well, big legs. We are done. Now, at the risk of you guys yelling at me, I'm probably going to go to... Oh yeah, I'm going to go to Joba first and check out those planets. Timey-wimey stuff.
Sometimes I forget how small we are.
Look at that. Is that an elliptical orbit? And no anomalies yet? Okay, so this is the Joba system, a half-four planet. Boop. That's a blinding sun right there. Pretty. A half-hour's non-standard orbit appears to be a natural phenomenon unrelated to the scourge. Our analysis suggests the orbit has been stable for a minimum of several hundred million years. Ronadin. Cool, look at that. You can see it right there. Is that a distortion caused by the black hole? Or an error with the game? Only from this way you could see like there's another planet behind it. It would be cool if that's an actual like distortion of light and stuff like that. Something like that. So yeah, Ronadin. Primitive ocean life thrives on this world, but ubiquitous maelstroms constantly batter the surface. If colonization is possible, it will be a long and difficult task. I don't know I'd want to colonize this a world like this. With the black hole looming in the distance like that. Tarosh. It's Seems relatively close by. Again, you can see this black hole. And you can see that. Does that only happen near the black hole? Look at that, now it's down there. Huh. Tarosh. It's an Angaran term meaning roughly cruel joke. There may be valuable minerals in the mountains, but massive electrical storms and punishing atmospheric pressure keep them locked away. Hmm. Cruel joke indeed. Okay. Last planet? Yeah, four planets. Latafo. Oh my. Again, that other planet behind it. So freaky. See it? Womp womp. On the outer edge of the Joba system, the lifeless world of Latafo creeps a few inches closer to the great black hole every year. Far in the future, it will be consumed. Okay, well, there's nothing much going on in this system. We didn't find any goodies. So we are done with Joba. Jojoba. So let's go to Nol, to Vold, to meet the resistance. Viva la revolution. Once we explore this system and the other, I think it's two systems of the Angarans in their sector of the cluster, whatever you call it. We might be 50 out of 50 or more for our scanning planets.
Anomaly on sensors.
Surprise, yeah, she didn't have anything to say when we were approaching. So we've got only three planets. The first one in Nol is Paz 55. Look at that twinkle there. Is that the anomaly? Or an anomaly? Bird in space.
Anomaly detected.
Yes. Hydrogen and methane comprise the bulk of Paz 55's atmosphere. Innumerable tiny satellites drift low in the gas giant's orbit, too dispersed to form a proper ring. This little thingy?
Deploying probe. Detecting what's left of a ship.
Cool. I love her accent. It's a cool, like, she's got, like, a computer voice, like, a cool computer voice accent. I forget. It's either a game or, like, a movie that has a starship voice similar to hers. Freaking awesome. I can't think of it, though. So the ship identity or identification is Yoni 011. Ship name, unknown. I'll just call it Yoni. Crew complement of 1. Status not available. This empty Angaran escape pod appears to have been drifting over Paz 55 for nearly a decade. Markings suggest it came from an exploratory vessel. Its data is now yours to carry forward. Well, I guess the person inside is dead, because I don't think you could carry enough food and water to last you nearly a decade. I got a bunch of crap. Beacon optics, biodisinfectant, ESO shunt, nanocrystal modules, and one or more other things that scrolled past too quickly. So, that's that.
Anomaly on sensors.
Going to Vold last. We go to Detivios. So I hope we get to go to the other planet and carry out the other, you know, quest afterwards. No spoilers though, guys. We'll find out in our own time. Por favor.
I'm picking up something.
She's picking up something. Detivios. Largely covered in oceans of nitrogen churned by powerful winds, the storms make detailed surface scans difficult. And we just saved the game for some reason. And we got some kind of... Is that a pole? Or some kind of huge storm?
Probe away. Anomaly found.
It's a storm. 130 kilometers in radius. Wind speed is 157 kilometers per hour. Rotating counterclockwise. This massive hurricane is carrying a sort of nitrogen-adapted plankton over the ocean. Detivios appears to be home to simple life forms. So it's carried this plankton. So I guess I'm gonna get XP from this. Yep, apparently so, in level 12. Here we are. Nice. We're learning things. Yeah, 270 XP. Anything else to find? Apparently not.
Anomaly on sensors.
Okay, there's an anomaly over here.
Probes launched. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Nice. I love the news you give me, Suvi. Awesome. It's an M-type asteroid. Honeycombed with artificial caverns. A few fragments of remnant technology remain, though it appears another party, perhaps the cat, removed the rest. But we did get 93 copper. Cool. Now we're heading to Vorwell, not gonna land there on this episode, because we are quite late, approaching the 40-minute mark. Turquoise, whitish tinge.
Okay, bundle up, people.
I'll stay on my nice warm ship.
Ooh, PB's secret project, meet the resistance and training favors. So we can take care of a few quests here. Maybe some of them eventually. Who knows if we can get to certain parts or not. Surface temperature is minus 40 degrees Celsius, so it's very cold. Vold is a world going through an ice age. Once packed with dozens of major urban centers, most of Vold's Angaran population now lives in scattered settlements. The remains of vast ancient cities are entombed in ice. Vold is a stronghold of the Ket. Caution advised. Landing zone. So, next episode would be landing on Vold. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.